this is your first time here in my channel. I'm Mom Shisan. I was a former nurse in the Philippines, and now I'm a stay-at-home mom. And also, please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon for you to get notified for my next videos about mom life, motherhood, life with kids, parenting tips, and also I'm sharing some lutong bahay recipes. For my parenting tips today, mga moms, isi-share ko sa inyo on how to raise a non-materialistic child. So, 2 days ago, napanood ko yung YouTube video ni Andy Eigenman about how to raise a non-materialistic children. Na-inspired ako sa video niya. So, that's why gusto kong i-share yung mga tips ni Andy Eigenman and some additional tips na din and my own opinion about it. So, let's get started. So, before tayo mag-start, mga moms, nga pala, konting disclaimer lang, okay? I'm not a parenting expert. I'm a first-time mom and my son is only 16 months old. But these ideas and tips, I will certainly and probably apply to my son. And so, itong mga tips na to and ideas na to, i-re-share ko lang just for you if you want, only if you want to raise a non-materialistic child. So, at the end of the day, your child, your rules. So, ikaw pa rin ang magde-decide for you on how to be a parent sa iyong anak and it's still your parenting style. Let's get started! Yung first natin, first tip is lead by example. So, yun yung first tip ni Andy Eigenman, which is, I definitely and super agree talaga to lead by an example. And also, I'd like to shout out Divine Grace Colacion. Divine Grace Colacion. She also said, be an example. Kasi nag-post ako sa Facebook ko, tinanong ko how to raise a non-materialistic child. So, meron isang sumagot. It's Divine Grace Colacion. Thank you so much for her answer. And I really, really appreciate her. So, yun nga. The first is be an example. So, kung gusto natin na palakihin ang ating mga anak na hindi materialistic, is to lead an example. Be an example to our kids. So for me and for my husband, matipid talaga kami. Wala kami mamahaling furnitures, hindi branded yung mga damit namin, or kung branded man, nabili namin second hand sa Goodwill or sa kumbaga ukay-ukay sa Pilipinas, ganon. So, masaya na kami sa mga simpleng bagay. Hindi namin kailangan ng mga mamahaling bagay para maging masaya. So, hindi namin kakailangan ng mamahaling material para maging masaya. So, ito yung example na gusto namin ipakita sa anak namin that you can be happy with simple things in life. You can be happy na hindi kailangan ng sobrang daming material na bagay sa buhay. Instead of rewarding them with all material things like gadgets or new toys, replace it with experiences or spending quality time with your kids. Maybe you can cook something nice, something special, or ipagluto mo siya ng favorite food niya, and that way you are also spending quality time with your kids by cooking something special, and that way pinapakita mo sa kanya na kinakongratulate mo rin siya sa magandang ginawa niya or sa magandang result ng kanyang hard work sa school, something like that. So yon. And tips number 3, pang third tips natin is huwag mong ibibigay lahat ng gusto niya or lahat ng request niya immediately or instantly. So yon. So sa anak ko, hindi pa masyadong applicable to kasi he's only 16 months old and hindi pa siya marunong mag-request ng kung anong gusto niya. So, to be honest, kami ng asawa ko, bilang na bilang lang yung mga toys na nabili namin para sa kanya. Karamihan ng toys na meron siya dito sa bahay is galing sa grandparents. So, yung grandparents yung palaging bumibili ng toys sa kanya. So, pag dumating yung time na marunong na mag-request or gustong humingi ng something yung anak ko, I'll definitely apply this rule, these tips. So, hindi hindi ko, for example, meron siyang hinihingi, Mommy, I want this phone. Mommy, I want this gadget. Mommy, I want this toy. And then mag-start siyang mag-tantrum, mag-iiyak dyan, maglumpasay dahil hindi, dahil gusto niya yung bagay na yun. For me, kung dumating ba yung time na yun, I don't think na ibibigay ko sa kanya yun immediately kasi pag binigay ko agad sa kanya yun immediately, hindi niya matututunan kung ano yung halaga ng bagay na hinihingi niya. I will do my best na iparealize anak ko na hindi lahat ng gusto mo ay makukuha mo instantly or immediately. May mga bagay na kailangan mong paghirapan bago mong makuha. So, yun yung rule na gusto kong ituro sa anak ko. Yung pang 4 tips is teach them act of kindness like generosity and helping others. So, teach your kids, let's teach our kids to learn to share. Because sharing is caring. So yun. And also to teach them to help others without expecting anything in return. So hindi natin kailangan tumulong sa kapwa nang may hinihintay na kapalit. If we are going to help others, gawin natin yun ng may pagkukusa at bukal sa loob. So ito din yung ipakita natin sa mga anak natin na kapag tumulong tayo sa kapwa, hindi tayo nag-i-expect ng kapalit. So kapag nakita ito ng mga anak natin sa atin na ginagawa natin to bilang magulang, most probably, very good example sa kanila yon at gagayahin nila yon pag lumaki na sila or habang lumalaki sila. So yon yung this is also one of my favorite tips. And pang 5! And yung pang 5 is practice gratitude. I super, super love this. Gratitude. 2 years ago, I started journaling. And part ng journal ko is gratitude. So every morning, nagsusulat ako ng every morning pagkagising ko sa umaga, nagsusulat ako ng 3 things I am grateful for today or 3 things I am grateful for this morning. Like, it doesn't have to be complicated. Like, I'm thankful for my family. I'm thankful for my life. I'm thankful for sunshine. Anything that you are grateful for that day, yun. So, and to be honest, 2 years when I started gratitude journal, my life has changed dramatically and drastically. You know, yung when I started waking up every day feeling grateful at nagpapasalamat ako sa Diyos, and my life I feel like my life has been more blessed. Yun, I feel more happier inside. So yung gratitude and practicing gratitude, this is definitely I'd like to share or I'd like to teach my son yung to practice gratitude, yung habang lumalaki siya, yung marunong siyang magpasalamat in small things in life. Yun, so kapag because when you are grateful in life, I feel like you will receive more blessings in life. Yung kahit it's normal na maraming pagsubok, pagsubok sa buhay, ang hirap ng buhay. But if you still find at least 3 things na ipagpapasalamat mo, it will send you a positive vibes in life. So, yun yung reason why I really love practicing gratitude. And of course, ituturo ko sa aking anak yung being grateful. Kapag grateful siya sa maliliit na bagay, hindi siya mag-i-expect na mga super daming material na bagay. So, it will make him less or at least become a non-materialistic child. So, yun yung 5 tips na nire-share ko from Andy on how to raise a non-materialistic child. But meron akong additional one, which is teach them about money. So since we are talking about non-materialistic child, let's add also about teaching them about money. Sabi nga, teach them while they are young. So habang bata pa sila, turuan din natin sila on how to manage finances. You know, how to save money. So that's it, mga mamshi. I hope nagustuhan niyo itong video na to and itong parenting tips na to. And I hope may nakuha kayong magandang lesson about this tips. But kagaya ng sinabi ko, it's at the end of the day, it's still your decision on how you want to be a parent to your child. Kagaya nga ng sinabi ng karamihan, it's your child, it's your rules. So, yun, it's still your, it's your parenting style on how you want to be a parent. These tips is only to give you an idea if you want to raise a non-materialistic child. So, that's it! So, thank you so much for watching, and if you have more additional tips or more suggestions on how to raise a non-materialistic child, please feel free to comment them below for us to learn more from you. I'd really, really appreciate it. So, thank you so much, and please, please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon below for you to get notified sa aking mga next videos about mom life, parenting tips, motherhood, and everything family lifestyle. Thank you so much! Happy mom life!